How do you develop a body paragraph for an informational essay with relevant and sufficient ideas? In this lesson, you will learn how to develop a body paragraph by choosing relevant and sufficient quotations and analysis. Let's review by taking a look at the assignment prompt. How does Abraham Lincoln appeal to his audience with logic, ethics, and emotion? After reading Lincoln's second inaugural address, write an essay that clearly and accurately describes the author's purpose and that makes important connections and distinctions between the types of appeals Lincoln uses. Support your discussion with evidence from the text. Now let's review the writing process for responding to a text. 1. Read closely and analyze. 2. Generate and plan. 3. Draft and revise. 4. Edit and publish. We've already read closely and analyzed the text. We've also generated ideas and came up with a plan for the assignment prompt, How does Abraham Lincoln appeal to his audience with logic, ethics, and emotion? Now we are going to start working on drafting the essay. Once you have brainstormed ideas for a paragraph, you are expected to formulate a paragraph appropriate to the audience's knowledge of the topic. This means that you'll want to ask yourself, who is my intended audience? And what does my audience already understand about the topic? You want to keep the audience's knowledge of the topic in mind so that you're sure to explain concepts that your audience doesn't understand, and you avoid explaining concepts that your audience already understands. Understanding your audience is one way to ensure that your ideas are relevant. So here are the steps for this lesson. 1. Review your two-column chart. 2. Select relevant and sufficient ideas that best fit the paragraph's main idea. And 3. Draft your ideas into a paragraph while keeping the audience in mind. First, review your two-column chart. So these are the notes that we took in the previous lesson. It's important to review your notes before moving on to the next step because you might think of something else to add, and while you read, you can also be thinking about which are your strongest. The paragraph's main idea is Lincoln uses logic to appeal to his audience's reasoning. We may want to add more to this so that it says what Lincoln's reasoning is. On the left, we have some quotes that say, "Both read the same Bible and pray to the same God, and each invokes his aid against the other. The prayers of both could not be answered. That of neither has been answered fully. The Almighty has his own purposes. He gives to both north and south this terrible war as the woe due to those by whom the offense of slavery came." So on the other side of our analysis says, "Since both sides are asking the same God to do the opposite, it is impossible for both sides to get their way." He uses an if-then structure to reach a logical conclusion, and his argument is based on their common belief in God. So next, select relevant and sufficient ideas that best fit the paragraph's main idea. For this step, we will select ideas that show how Lincoln appeals to logic. If we do this, it'll help ensure that the selections are relevant. Let's select the first two quotes because the first quote seems to establish a basis for what Lincoln says in the second quote. Let's select all of the analysis to ensure that a sufficient amount of ideas are given. Remember, I only gave you three examples of quotes and three examples of analysis for the purpose of this lesson. In reality, the more ideas you write down, the stronger your essay is likely to be because you'll have enough ideas that you can leave out weaker quotes and analysis. Now, draft your ideas into a paragraph while keeping the audience in mind. Let's remember to keep the audience's knowledge of the topic in mind so that we explain concepts that the audience probably doesn't understand. And let's avoid explaining concepts that the audience already understands. So before starting, it might be a good idea to use another piece of paper or document to write your first draft on. Let's start with the main idea of the paragraph. Lincoln uses logic to appeal to his audience's reasoning, And I'm going to add, to declare that both the north and south are off track. Next, let's add the first quotation that lays the foundation for Lincoln's argument. He states, both read the same Bible and pray to the same God, and each invokes his aid against the other. Now let's add our first analysis that explains the quotation. Since both sides are asking the same God to do the opposite, it is impossible for both sides to get their way. Now we'll add our next quotation. Lincoln says, the prayers of both could not be answered. That of neither has been answered fully. The Almighty has his own purposes. As I look at the last two pieces of analysis, I think they could be combined to say, Lincoln uses an if-then structure to reach a logical conclusion based on his audience's common belief in God. At this point, the paragraph seems to have relevant and sufficient ideas to explain the paragraph's main idea. We may need to add a sentence to transition into the next paragraph, but we can do this later. The paragraph is a rough draft that we can add to or detract from if needed. So up to this point, we have written a rough outline and a thesis statement. We have taken our notes and written a rough draft of the first body paragraph. I recommend following the same steps we just completed in order to draft the other body paragraphs. Now let's take a look at the big picture of the writing process. We have just finished writing a body paragraph draft. It's important to write the other body paragraph drafts at this time. Next, we will be drafting the introduction and conclusion paragraphs. So here are the steps from this lesson. 1. Review your two-column chart. 2. Select relevant and sufficient ideas that best fit the paragraph's main idea. And 3. Draft your ideas into a paragraph while keeping the audience in mind. In this lesson, you have learned how to develop a body paragraph by choosing relevant and sufficient quotations and analysis.